Welcome back to The Average Drinker. I'm Dara, I'm your average drinker, and we've got Bill here again, but this time it's not for a blind. Well, not exactly.
Sort of.
It kind of is, I guess you could say that. So, in this video, we're going to tell you how we practice our palate, because, well, as you know, I'm super competitive, and I really, really, really want to get into World Top Whiskey Taster this year, and I'm in Matt Madness. If this has already happened, like if you're watching this after Matt Madness already happened, well, I hope I did good, because I'm super freaking competitive, and all I want to do is win. So, in order to win, you just got to practice, and your palate changes all the time, right?
Uh-huh.
Like, we could try something 6 months ago, and it tastes way different than it does now. So that's why we practice. We try to grow our palate, get better at it. And so we kind of have a process on what we do. We have a blind sheet that we do for our battles. You can find it on Patreon. Sorry, shameless Patreon plug. Go check it out. But this is a sheet that we use to practice our palate. And on the sheet, you have like proof, style, if it's finished or not, brand, and bottle. And so you have to like write down all of that and then... The person, like, we do four samples at a time, and
yep.
I picked Bill's, so I pour four random samples, he poured me four random samples. There was one rule, well, I guess, would you say two rules?
Well, there's at least one rye and one bourbon. We know there are ryes and bourbons, that's all here. We didn't put in scotches or Irish or anything like that. So there could be three ryes and a bourbon, two bourbons, two ryes, or three bourbons, one rye. We just know there's at least one of each, so we at least have some frame of reference for what we're tasting.
Right. So we've got that. So he poured mine, I poured his, and what we're going to do in this video is going to be a little bit different. I brought him along because we wanted to do this. It might get kind of boring if I'm just sitting here.
Yeah, and we do this a lot anyways, just not on screen, but you want to explain the point thing with it?
Oh, yeah. So... Here's the point system. I'll explain the point system, and then we'll kind of go into some other stuff. But so here's how the point system works. So you get 1 point for guessing within plus or minus 4 proof points. So like if it's 116 points and you guess, 116 proof and you guess 120, you get it right. Or if you guess 112, then you get it right. So within 4, plus minus. And then you get 1 point for guessing style, whether it's a bourbon, rye, scotch, whatever. You get a point for guessing if it's finished or not. You get 2 points for guessing the brand, so like Stag, Knob Creek,
yep.
etc. And then you get 5 points if you guess the exact bottle. So, pretty fun. We both guessed the bottle a few times
yep.
in our practices. We do this a lot when we're off camera, like Bill said. So, now we're going to kind of pretend like we're not on camera. We're just going to do this how we do it. We're going to set our timer for 3 minutes. And 3 minutes, we're going to do the first one, and then we'll write down our guesses for the first one, and then we'll set another 3 minutes, and then we'll set another 3 minutes, and then, you know, you caught the drift. So, we're going to do this. Hopefully, it's not super boring for you. It's just, we want to give you insight into how we do it, and how I practice, how Bill practices, and how we get better, we hope.
Yeah, and we might not necessarily talk about the nose palette or anything like that during this. I mean, we'll throw stuff out, we'll write stuff down every once in a while, but I'm already... I had a cigar earlier, so.
Oh, yeah. And we've eaten some weird food, so.
Yeah, so we'll see what happens, but we'll see if I can keep my winning streak going.
Oh, you're going down. I'm about to guess a bottle.
Are you?
Okay. I'm going to guess a bottle.
Okay.
All right. So, without further ado, let's do this. Are you ready? Who's going to win? Oh, yeah? Yeah? No. It's going to be me. All I do. I don't know. I don't want to, like, talk myself up, so. All right, let's do this. We'll start with number one. We'll set the timer. We'll kind of, I don't know, who knows what will happen in the next 3 minutes, but we're going
to
do it.
I'm kind of interested to see, because we haven't done this with a timer before. We usually just do it. And with her, time constraints will be fun.
I'm not worried about the time constraint. I'm excited. So,
okay,
all right,
okay.
On your mark, get ready, get set, go!
Go.
Ooh, it smells nice on the nose. It smells nice. Yeah, I'm a little bit worried about the time. And I'm also worried because the camera's on me, so I'm going to pretend that the camera's not there. Just do this.
She gets flustered very easily.
Oh, thanks. I do. Yeah. I do certainly get flustered a little bit. The easiest ones for me are usually if it's bourbon or rye and if it's finished or not. That's like the first thing I try to get down, personally. Hmm. I got a little nose hair burn right there. Just a little bit. Tinging. I always say tinging the nose hairs, but I don't even know what that means.
This does not taste too high a proof.
And mine actually tastes high proof. I'm like, we're going out. We're going big here. Going big.
I have a guess on what this is. Hmm. But it's been a little bit since I've had this. Ooh. If it, I don't know.
For me, I don't know if this is like because the first pour I've had in a while, but whew, that's warm. We drank some earlier to film another video, but feels hot, that's for sure. Tastes good.
And no cheating looking back there like you usually do.
I'm not going to look back. Woo! My ears are like...
I can't tell if this is a higher proof or not. It just makes me think of one bottle, but... And I'm going towards that bottle, but I don't know if that's a good way to go with this.
Got a minute and 15 seconds left. I got an idea. Oh! Hmm. Dang. Is that what that is? No. Ugh. There's something on this nose that makes me think of MGP, but I don't think it is.
And then I don't know if I'm getting a little bit extra spice on my tongue because of the chicken with wing sauce that I had for dinner.
I know, because that's what's making this one seem really hot to me. I think I know what mine is.
Yeah, and I don't remember if we said, we'll go over all four of them at the end.
Whatever this is, I like this one.
Well, that's good.
Do you like yours?
I do. I'm just trying to, I have a guess for what it is. I think I'm wrong, though. I'm keeping what I had, but I think I'm wrong. I have a second guess, but I'm just leaving it.
Yeah, I think I have a good guess.
Good? You actually finished ahead of time. There's 10 seconds left. 10 seconds left. Wow. That surprised me.
6, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, there's that timer.
Ooh, I need to
take. Yep, take a sip of water here.
Whew, that was warm.
If that's my other guess, I kind of hedge my bet on the proof. So
I'm trying to read what yours said, but I can't tell.
You'll see at the end.
This is going to be fun. I'm actually kind of pumped to see. This is actually kind of fun to do it with the camera on.
Yep.
And the timer.
Yep. Are you ready for the next one?
Yep. Let's go.
Round two. Fight.
Oh.
It smells good. I don't know what it is, but it smells
good. Holy floral.
Yes. Should I do the...
It makes fun of me, but that's why I do.
The mic's like right here. And so when she films these, you just hear.
This is a ridiculous amount of floral. I mean, like, holy floral. I know I'm not giving you notes, but.
What is that? Oh. Is it?
Oh, geez. This is hard.
That has a flavor, but I just don't know what that is. I know I've had it.
Gotta go with your guts. I might screw this one up, guys.
Oh, what is this?
One thing I like to do is kind of smell the other ones.
Don't go... No. It's one sample at a time. You're not doing other ones.
Dang it! Sometimes I...
That's one sample at a time.
Sometimes
that's a foul. Lose points.
I didn't.
Points deducted.
I did not even smell it. I'm going to struggle on this one, guys.
Huh. I don't remember the proof of that, but I don't quite get that.
Shoot, I'm going to run out of time.
This one's tough for me to figure out what it is.
Me too.
It's drinking warm.
I'm nervous.
I think that's a proof of that one. That's probably actually a little bit higher, but I'm going with my first guess and being done. Do, 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 do. Wait, is that the Jeopardy song? Doop, 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 doop.
I don't know what
that is. Oh, that's so wrong.
You can't do that.
Oh, I love messing with her. I can't wait till you're on Matt Madness with people talking back and forth. Seeing if you can withstand the pressure. Uh-oh.
I got it.
Sample two.
I think that's what that thing is called.
What?
The one I just wrote down. I don't know what that is.
Yeah. We'll find out.
Find out later. I'm definitely not right, but...
So far, the first two I've had are good.
Yeah. Mine too. I was definitely not right, but that was the first guess I got, so I just went with it.
Yeah. It's not Wabash.
Mm-mm. Jeez, it sounds like Jade is having a party upstairs.
Yeah, who knows? She's probably sitting at the top of the stairs just like waiting for something.
Are you ready for number three?
Yep. Round three.
Yep.
And go.
Oh, I know that one, the nose. I know that one.
That's a rye.
Mine too.
Yep, that is a rye for sure.
That's weird. Mine is a rye too, but it has like a weird like, it might be like a toasted rye or something. Yeah, it might be a toasted rye. Hmm. I should taste it before I write down a guess. Hmm. I've had this before. Oh shit, I know what, shit, I think I know what that is. I don't think that is a rye.
I like this. It's got an interesting flavor to it.
This nose is very familiar. It's not Rebel Root Beer.
Rebel Root Beer. It's not Rebel Root Beer. But that is good. Where is that bottle?
Right there.
Oh, yep. Yeah, yeah, Rebel Root Beer, if you ever want a, like, I think it's like 70 proof. It's like basically Rebel 100. No, not, it wouldn't be Rebel 100. It's the Rebel... bourbon, but it has root beer flavoring, and it tastes exactly like one of those root beer barrel candies. It's delicious.
This one is like a huge drop in proof from the last two. Now, if I can, I'm trying to do this without looking back there, like memory, what this is.
No, I'm done. A minute, 15 seconds left.
I think mine's a toasted rye. I just don't know. I think it might be like... I haven't had that Bourbon Junkies toasted rye yet, so that's what's throwing me off, because I don't know what that tastes like. But my gut is telling me that this is a toasted rye. I don't know what the proof is. I don't know anything about it. But it has that Nulu flavor. That's what I'm going, Nulu toasted rye.
That's what I wrote down for this. I wrote down Nulu toasted. I will say that. Watch, we poured the exact same thing for each other and wrote down the exact same thing, but they're completely wrong.
That would be really
funny. It'd be really good.
All right, I gotta get a proof on this.
Yeah, don't look at mine. You don't know the proof. Uh-oh, 20 seconds.
I have no idea. I don't know what the proof of that is. Oh,
whoa.
Okay.
We got three samples done. That's quick.
I think that's quicker at this than we think we
are. Yeah. Well, the squirrel moments, and then as you get drunk more, the longer it takes.
Yeah.
Oh. Alrighty. You ready for sample four? See what happens? See if I can retain my winning streak on these, or if Dara's going to take the crown from me again.
I don't know, but here's what I'm thinking.
Well, we got the sheets down over there. I can get them out with all the points.
No, here's what's weird to me. We were pretty even. You had a couple
points. I have you beat by like a point or two right now.
So, after, I'm either like way off on two or three on the proof, because the level that number three drank like was way less than number two did. That's just for reference, but I only put them 5 proof points apart. So in my mind, I probably, like, if I would go, could go back in time, I'd probably change that, but I'm just going to leave it for what it is. You can't
go back in time.
No, I can't, but I'm just saying. You don't have a DeLorean. No, I'm just saying, though, whatever that means. Is that like Star Wars or something?
It's Back to the Future. Come on.
Oh, Back to the Future. I've seen that.
88 miles per hour. And then you go back to the future. You can go back or to the future.
If I go to the future, then we can be engaged and we can get married. Okay. Are you ready for?
I'm ready for four.
I'm ready.
Let's do this. And go.
I think we're doing good. I don't know.
Whoa.
What
is that? What is that? I like it. Whatever it is. What is it? I don't know.
I like it, whatever.
It's got an interesting smell and I like it.
Mine too. Mine smells a little bit nutty brown sugary.
Whoa!
Like a Knob Creek or a Booker's or a...
The taste, I think that...
It doesn't smell hot though. Holy brown sugar.
Damn, this one has me confused. This one has me confused. What would that be? Because I'm not getting like banana-y, so it's not making me think towards Jack Daniels. Or the... I think that Foolproof has a pretty good banana to it. Usually Old Forester has banana. All Brown-Forman type stuff, but... Got a hint of butterscotch there. Did you pour me the new smoke wagon that I haven't drank much?
No, I didn't.
What the hell is that? I am so confused on that one right now.
On number four?
Yes.
Huh.
Huh.
What is the... I want to look back so fast.
This one's screwing with me. What did you pour me? Seriously. This is the only one that I just do not know.
Yeah, me either.
I don't...
I know this is not right, but this is what I'm going to go with because I can't... I'm running out of time.
Yeah, we got 4 seconds. I'm probably completely wrong on that one.
I need to look now because I know what that is, but I just can't put my nose on it.
That one, that four you poured me is high proof, and I was thinking it was like a Booker's or something, but I wasn't getting peanut. I wasn't getting banana-y stuff like from an old Jack Daniels or Old Forester. It's a high proof,
see, whatever mine, it is. I was getting the peanuts on mine, but I wasn't getting that high proof like I thought, well, like a Booker's or something. All right. That was fun.
Ready to find out what these are?
Sorry, that was rude. So excuse me. I usually do that on Patreon, not on like this reading. Yeah. Okay, so
you want to go first? Or you want me to go first? Or we'll do each sample.
Oh, we'll go one by one.
Yep.
And then we'll like final
sample one for each of us.
Okay, you go first.
So I guess 96 proof.
Wrong. It's 90.
Oh, I just missed it.
Mm-hmm.
Damn it. I had bourbon.
Yes.
Do you not know what you poured me? I had not finished.
Not finished.
Correct. And then I put Evan Williams single barrel.
It's the old Forrester single barrel. The one, the 90 total wine.
Do I get single barrel right? No. Wait, the old fair, is that 90 or is that 100?
It's 90. The, oh, sorry. Sorry.
The total wine one?
The total wine is 90. Yep.
90, okay.
90 proof.
So I got 2 points on that one.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. What's your sample? What's your guess?
So sample one, I said 127 proof.
134.3. No points on that one.
Dang it. Oh, wait. Oh, 134. Yep. Shoot. I was going to go with... Trats. I was going to go with 130.
Yep.
I should have... by.
You wouldn't have got it with 130.
Dang it. Okay, bourbon.
Correct.
Okay, so hold on. So 134.4. It is a bourbon. Yeah. I said not finished.
Correct.
Hold on. Let me do points. So 0, 1. Okay, not finished. So plus 1. I said Booker's Tag Along.
No, that was Old Forester single barrel strength. So 0-0. We tied.
We tied on that first round.
Yep, we're tied 2-2 going into the second sample.
We both put Old Forester on the first one.
Yeah. Both single barrels, just one barrel strength, one not.
Okay. SIB barrel. I almost poured that one for you, actually. I was going to pour you like hilarious. A whole Old Forester lineup.
I'm curious to see what 3 is going to be, actually.
Okay, so you go to 2.
Okay, 2. I said 110 proof.
Wrong. It's 100.
Oh, damn. I said bourbon.
Correct.
And then I said not finished.
Correct.
And then I said the Bullet Justin's House of Bourbon single barrel.
It is Heaven Hill.
That's kind of what I was thinking that number one was at first.
So you got 2 points.
The Heaven Hill.
Again. Right?
So this is that's the Heaven Hill bottle and bond?
Mm-hmm.
Or wait, no, the...
The Heaven Hill bottle
year,
and bond.
The 7-year bottle and bond.
Yeah. It's Heaven Hill bottle and bond. 100 proof. It's the bottle and bond.
I didn't know if it was the 7... That's I think that's like 6 or 7 years.
Who knows?
7. So a whopping 2 points again for me. So I'm up to 4. All right.
All right. This one was a little tough for me, but I should have said, I don't know. I have a guess, a secondary guess, but okay, 115 proof.
122.5.
See, and I knew that. I said that. Remember when I said I should have went higher? I said my gut said I should have been at 120.
Trust it.
And that's what I put first. So just so you know, I put 120 first. And I put 115 after. Crossed it out. Here's my paper for you guys to see. I did cross that out. You can't see it. Okay, bourbon?
Correct.
So you said 122.2 bourbon, so I got
122.5, but close enough.
Bourbon, so 0, 1. I said it was finished.
It is not finished.
Okay, then I'm wrong. 0, Blackened Willet was what I guessed.
I almost poured that for you.
Because it had like an
I almost poured that for you for
is
number
four. Is
it
Four Roses?
No, that is George Remus, Justin's House of Bourbon pick.
Oh, dang it. The flavor, the fruity flavor. See, it was a fruity note.
The blueberry note.
Yeah, but I get that in the blackened.
There's a note on 3 when I say it.
So
we were talking about the note on 3 this weekend with Mike.
Anyhow, what I want to say to you is on number 2, I did get that fruity note that I typically get in the either Four Roses, the Blackened Willet, and then the George Remus. So
the Blackened Willet's good. And I think that is 115 proof. So your guess would have been right for that.
And it is finished.
Yeah, it's like Madeira finish.
Which
I like that.
It's the fruity note. So it wasn't completely wrong.
No, that
it just was a little...
That George
I just
Remus
saw one.
Does have like a
so
blueberry.
You're beating me by one. It's George... I love that George Remus. It's really good. The Justin House of Bourbon pick.
Yep.
What'd you go with all Justin's House of Bourbon?
Nope.
For the
I guessed Justin's House of Bourbon. I only gave you one.
Okay. No, last one was one.
No,
was
it wasn't.
Oh, no, it wasn't.
I guessed Justin's House of Bourbon.
Oh, that's what you did. Okay.
That's why I couldn't figure it out. It's like, is there a banana flavor? I don't know, but anyway.
Okay, no, under 3. Number 3.
3. I guessed 112.
8 plus 4 is 12. You got that one right.
What is it?
It's 108.
Oh, yes.
You barely.
I'll take it. I guessed rye.
Correct.
Oh, I know what this is now that it's 108. That's the Pursuit United, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I didn't guess that. I said it was finished, which is not.
It's not finished.
And then I said the Nulu, the BJ's pick.
So you got one.
Once I heard 108, I knew exactly
you
what
knew
it was.
You knew what it was, yeah. It's kind of fun. We love doing these. They're actually really fun.
So I got...
It's fun to battle.
I got 2 points.
What, proof?
The Ryan... Proof and style.
Okay, so... Now
I'm
mine.
At 6.
And I'm at 3. But okay. I haven't done mine yet. Okay, so I said 110 proof.
Oh, 106.1. You got it. I wish it was 105.9.
You barely got yours, too. So, plus one. Okay, rye.
Correct.
I said it's finished.
It is not.
Oh, shit. Okay, I'm wrong. I said newly toasted rye because it's one I haven't had, I don't think. Yeah.
So, do you still have a little bit of that left?
Yeah.
Do you get a coffee flavor out of that? We were talking about that this weekend with Mike.
Oh, is that Stellum?
No.
I do.
It's that New Riff single barrel rye.
Okay, no, yep. But this is what I got out of it. This is why I said it. It smells toasted. There's like this...
It has like a coffee smoke. Flavor to it.
It's not a peat smoke, but it is like a roasted. Mm-hmm. It's a roasted
note.
Yeah,
like roasted coffee beans.
Toasted.
Whatever.
No, I'm just saying. Do not understand yeah. Where I got toasted.
Yeah.
Okay, so wait. So it's not finished. So I got 2 on that?
You got 2 on that one.
So it was the new Riff. Okay.
Yep, the New Riff.
The single bear SIB rye. Okay, so 2 and so I'm behind 1.
Yep.
And okay, going all right. Into the last one.
Going into L final.
Scared.
Okay, so this was a high one. I said 127.
You got it.
Is it exactly 127?
No, it's 124.7.
No. 124.7. I might have got the bottle on this one.
What did you?
I said bourbon.
What was it, bourbon?
I said not finished.
Not finished.
I said Blue Note Juke Joint.
No.
Oh, damn it.
You're not right. I even gave you a hint in the middle of it, and I didn't realize I did. I was like, shit, I gave him a hint.
So, what is it?
It's Booker's Tagalong, or Booker's Country Ham.
Ah! I almost wrote that one, because I was like...
I gave him a hint.
I was like, this is high proof. I was like, I think it might be a Booker's. No. It's like, she wouldn't pour Country Ham, maybe Tagalong.
So, right before...
But then I was like, I'm not getting a peanutty flavor from it. And that's what turned me away from that, and I wasn't getting banana, which turned me away... Damn it, that was
okay,
in my mind.
So right before he said all that, I said something like, this could be, I said, this is, mine is not a Booker's Country Ham because it's not that high, like, I said, it's not that high approved, but it tastes, so yes, I gave him a hint.
What
I
was
felt
it,
like,
Country Ham?
Yeah, said? Country okay. Ham.
I almost
so
wrote
you
that
So you got 2 again.
I got 3.
3, okay.
So I have, what was that, 2, 4, 6, 9 points.
We're coming down to it. Can I get it?
Okay.
I'm nervous.
Let's see.
I don't think so.
Okay. Okay, go.
He already is excited because he's going to beat me.
Go.
But I couldn't come up with the bottle. So anyway, okay. So 110 proof.
Wait, I want it before you go with this. Do you like number 4?
What is like Maker's Mark or something? I don't... Is Evan Williams...
Do you like number 4 or not?
I didn't love it, no.
Okay.
I said I didn't love it. I just... It's a lot of peanuts for me.
The whiskey world is going to hate her.
I said I don't love it.
You might want to change your decision on that.
It's fine.
Okay. You said 110?
Hold on. I just said it's a lot of peanuts. Mm. Like, it's freaking loaded with peanuts.
You said 110?
Yeah. It tastes really light.
What's Do you want me to just get the bottle?
No, just tell me, Jesus.
So 110 is wrong. The proof is going to give you the answer is.
What's the proof?
101.
It's Wild Turkey 101.
That would be Wild Turkey 101.
So I got 2 points.
2, yeah. You said it was bourbon, you said not finished, and then what was your guess?
I said Knob Creek single barrel, like the one, the lower proof one.
Then we only have... So that would be 12 years.
That's 100. What I mean. Knob Creek 12 years.
12 years, 100 proof.
Okay, Knob Creek.
Single barrel is 120 proof. You just cut them in the middle.
No, what I meant. Okay, I did mean the 12 year. But yes, so 2 points for me. That means 2, 4, 6, 7. I lost by 2. You beat me by 2.
Still reigning champion.
I'm mad. No, I like it. It's fine. I said it's fine. I just thought for once that was like a lot. Normally, I don't get all the dusty peanuts off of Wild Turkey 101 like normal people do, but I guess in this blind, I did. Did you get the dusty peanuts normally? sounded like I said dusty penis. Anyhow.
There's a little. Put that cherry.
And I think my tongue was burned off after this. I don't know. The newly toasted, well, it wasn't newly toasted, but the toasted flavor threw me off on this last one. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Like sometimes like a flavor before that can throw your nose off. Anyhow.
Wild Turkey 101.
You trickster.
Boom. She doesn't like it, apparently.
No, I like it. I didn't say I don't like it. I said it's fine. It's fine. It's literally Wild Turkey 101 is like one of my favorite pours. But when you compare them to all the bottles that we had right here, that's hard to say. Like, that's better than them.
I'm just giving you hell.
Oh, my God. So, abuse. It was a close one. It was really a close one.
Abuse.
It was a close one. Mm-hmm. And we had fun. This is how, end of story here. This is how we practice our palate. Like, for me, I mean, I am literally, this is my first year drinking whiskey. So, the fact that I'm already doing, I'm doing okay. I'm figuring it out. Bill's been drinking whiskey a lot longer than me. He's had more practice, but he didn't do a lot of blinds before this.
No, not at all.
So, it's practice for both of us. It's a lot of fun. And, yeah, we're going to keep doing it.
Well, do you guys like this type of video? Or we're just kind of randomly BSing, going through blinds on how we kind of do our...
Our process?
Our process of kind of helping our palates and understanding some of these whiskeys. If so, we can definitely record more of these. It's kind of off the cuff and just...
Unfiltered, uncut, like all the things that we do, just us. So let us know what you think. Leave a note in the comments, I guess. I'm just losing my brain now because I'm like all flustered because I lost and I hate losing. I hate losing. I know. I lost a freaking... So I really did think it was Knob Creek 12 years. So for whatever it's worth... They Knob could Creek be actually. Actually, we could. We should do a video comparing Knob Creek 12 year to Wild Turkey 101.
There's a big price difference there too.
There's a huge price difference, but also I think there's a lot of similarities.
Try it.
Anyhow, as always, thank you guys so much for watching. Let us know what you think. If you hated this video, that's fine. Whatever, it's your own opinion. But we had fun doing it, and this is what we do during the weeknight and on the weekends. So, cheers. Have a great day, and. Yeah, we'll see you next time.